don't need a high-end designer or a lot of money to get a luxe look. Be your own interior designer.
This is Affordable Interior Design, the podcast.
Here's your host, Betsy Hellman.
My first question comes from Irina. Irina writes, "Hi, Betsy. I have a question for your podcast. I've been working at home for the last 7 months, and with the pandemic being nowhere near the end, I realized I need more comfortable areas in my house to work and to lounge. I have a traditional dining table in my house, but I noticed that we almost never use it. Probably because it's an IKEA table with 4 wooden chairs and pillow tie-downs. It feels rather uncomfortable, and it is too formal. I was wondering if having a corner banquette instead of a couple of chairs would be a better idea. That way I can relax, I can lean back, maybe even put my feet up when I work, or sit cross-legged while I eat in front of my laptop. What do you think? Is it too old school? For some reason, most furniture stores don't have a lot of choices. The only one I found is at Pottery Barn. I would love to hear your opinion and if you have any tips on how to make the dining room more inviting and comfortable. My house is small, so I'm trying to find creative ways to work from different places for changing scenery's sake. Thank you. I hope your back is feeling better. Longtime listener, Irina." Irina, did you know that my back actually had some flare-ups? So thank you for asking. It was flaring up. I was having some more uncomfortability. So my son was on the Affordable Interior Design baseball team. We sponsored the Little League team for our town, and they came in second place. Very sad, but they put in such a great effort, and everybody really was amazing. And the final game was out of control. I mean, I was jumping up and down with my bad back. And my voice was hoarse for 2 days afterwards. Anyway, I digress. So after the big championship game, my husband, who is the coach, full disclosure, he planned a parents versus kids game. And I couldn't play because of my back. I was worried that if I run, if I hit a ball, if I overexert myself, that I'll hurt myself again. And I felt so left out because all the parents were playing, because 2 years ago when we had that parents kids game, I played and really did a good job. So I was hoping to put in another amazing showing. Well, I was sitting on the sidelines with one other mom, and she's like, "Why aren't you playing?" And I mentioned my back issue. She had the same issue, read the same book by Dr. Sarno, and was healed. Then she went to some sort of energetic healer in the city and got even more great feedback on what emotional issues were actually causing her back flare-ups. And so she gave me the name of that person, but immediately after talking to her, like the very next day, my back issues went away. And, you know, I really believe that they are 100% tied to my stress levels, my overwhelm. Dr. Sarno says it's internalized rage. So I just thought that that was so interesting, and I have not had any back troubles since. I used to have back troubles every night sitting in my armchair. I couldn't even sit on the couch. And after talking with her again, even though, you know, I already had listened to 2 chapters of Dr. Sarno's book, I'd already been partially healed, but I was in the middle of a flare-up. And just being able to emotionally know what's going on has really been so liberating. So the only reason I'm sharing this story, even though I think it's cool and it made me feel less alone on a day when I was feeling left out because I wanted to play, the only reason I'm really sharing this story is because I bet a lot of you are struggling with back pain. And I'm not saying that this is going to help everyone, but if you would have told me a year ago, almost a year ago, that if I just knew that my back pain was internalized rage, I could make it go away, I mean, that would have been, first of all, unbelievable to me. And second of all, something that I would have wanted to try. Okay, let me just tap into my internalized rage here. So if that helps you guys in any way, I just wanted to put that out there. And Irina, thanks for asking about my back. Let's get back to your question. So, you know, I think banquette seating can be comfortable for the right type of person. The problem with banquette seating when you buy these prefab banquettes from, say, Pottery Barn or Ballard Designs, is typically they're in a small L-shaped configuration, meaning that they truly dictate the size of your table. And if you have a small L shape like the one you showed me from Pottery Barn, you must use it with a small circular table, or you could use it with like a square type table. But basically, because the banquette is equidistant on each side, the table needs to be equidistant on each side, which can be quite limiting. So I'm just hesitant, because this is your formal living room, I'm wary that that will actually work for a formal living room when you can at max seat, you know, I don't know, maybe three people on the banquette and then two people in additional chairs at a 42-inch round table. I'm just worried that even though it's more comfortable for you day to day to put up your feet, to, you know, sit cross-legged while you're working, I think that it does present those limitations. If the limitations I spoke about don't feel limiting to you, then go for it. I do think that the banquette is much more expensive than just getting separate chairs. And for me, it sounds like the culprit in your situation is that the chairs just aren't comfortable. You know, those tie-on cushions aren't all they're cracked up to be. And the table is IKEA. IKEA is 80% crap, 20% gold. I do think that there are some amazing pieces at IKEA, but the crappy pieces really impact your quality of life. So if you're not finding enough banquette selection to float your boat, or if the banquette is limiting you to a circular or square table, I would advise that you get four chairs at a rectilinear table that sits six. And then on one of the sides of the table, one of the long rectangular sides, I would do a bench with a back. That way you can get the experience of having a place to sit where you can put your feet up, but you're not literally pinned in to that prefab banquette. If this is going to be a place where you stay forever, if this is going to be a place that, you know, you feel comfortable making the investment of a built-in banquette is going to give you more options in terms of making one side longer and one side shorter. So that way you can seat more comfortably. You could have a rectilinear table, but just keep in mind, as I'm sure we can all remember from sitting at diners or even Outback Steakhouse, or while on vacation in Maine, we drove through Boston, we ate at the 99. They have really good banquettes, but once you get more than three people on one side of a banquette, it's quite uncomfortable. I have to ask Diane to move and Eden to move. That was my recent experience, so that I could use the restroom, right? So speaking of pinned in, you're kind of locked in again, which for some is uncomfortable. And so I just want you to think about that when you're really thinking about how many people a bench or banquette can sit. All right, Irina, I'm happy to have been of help. A big thank you to our amazing producer, Catherine Heller, to Eitan and the MBCR House Band, and to Affordable Interior Design, the sponsor of this podcast and the premier place to get an amazing look on a budget. Check out affordableinteriordesign.com. If you guys love the show, the very best way to support us is by spreading the word. Tell your friends, or write us an awesome review on iTunes. So until next week, guys, thanks so much for joining us, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye.